today we're talking about former finance minister and probably soon to be two-time former home affairs minister Gigaba. And let me tell you, this guy's bounced around ministerial positions like a beach ball at a concert. So what's going on with him? Well, according to News 24, last year he was found to have deliberately told untruths under oath and also violated the Constitution. And it's never a good sign for your case when reporting doesn't even lead with the fact that you violated the rules that literally constitute the basic building blocks for your society. So what happened and why is it being reported on today? Well, the main scandal, of which, of course, there are other smaller ones involving the Guptas, a family that spends so much time bribing the government, I'm surprised South Africa hasn't turned a profit. This scandal involves a different powerful family, the Oppenheimers.
Affairs Minister Malusi Gigaba failed in his attempt to appeal against a High Court judgment, which found he had lied under oath in his legal battle with the Oppenheimer family.
This scandal took place the last time this guy was Home Affairs Minister, which worked out so well that Ramaphosa decided to rehire him. I told you this guy bounces around. Alright, so what did he do? Well, this all comes down to the Johannesburg O.R. Tambo International Airport, in which an aviation company owned by the Oppenheimers successfully obtained permits to operate their own immigration terminal. Now, that might sound a little suspicious, but that might actually be the most legitimate part of this entire story. The problem comes when it came to light that the Oppenheimers held secret talks with the African National Congress Party over their application to open their own terminal in the South African International Airport. Now, again, this might seem like it would be the problem here, but it's not. All I can say is, warmer. So alright, you have a secret meeting between one of the wealthiest families in South Africa and a political party, and 2 months later that family gets approval for their aviation company, Fireblade Aviation, to get their own terminal. First off, great name. Two things I want to think about when I'm getting on a plane are fire and blades. This is why you don't let a 9-year-old name your company. Second, and probably more importantly, this green light was given by Home Affairs Minister Gigaba. Now, before I go on, I want to stress that the ANC had previously written to Nikki Oppenheimer that his terminal application had met the necessary requirements. And let me tell you, we could have an entire hour-long episode on the ethics of this terminal, but for the purposes of this trial, the terminal is legitimate. The problem is what happened next. A twist so sudden it might even leave M. Night Shyamalan speechless.
It is a case against the Minister of Home Affairs, where the Minister of Home Affairs clearly stated in the case that South African law does not permit a private family to own an airport.
Ding ding ding, we have ourselves a constitutional crisis. Alright, so I have to explain one thing a little bit, because the opening of the terminal sounds like it would be the problem after seeing that clip. But the Fireblade terminal is now open and servicing private aircrafts entering South Africa without a hitch. No, in this case the problem lies with Gigaba, because soon after approving the terminal, he took some advice from Shaggy and consistently publicly said, yeah, he denied approving the terminal, a position that every court so far has called his bluff on. But he maintains that position. He tried to appeal to the Constitutional Court, but they rejected his application, and he's currently trying to appeal to the Supreme Court for lying under oath. And his response to all these rejections? It's so bad that a judge from the ruling he's trying to appeal described his arguments as disingenuous, spurious, and fundamentally flawed, labored and meritless, bad in law, astonishing, palpably untrue, untenable, and not sustained by objective evidence, uncreditworthy, and nonsensical. Wow, someone brought the thesaurus to work today. Tell me what you really think. To be fair, let's hear from the defendant.
It wasn't me.
Great. The problem was that this denying the approval of the terminal was leading to some serious problems beyond the obvious. Because at this point there was a terminal, but the House Affairs Department wasn't sending immigration officers to the terminal, which was causing a bit of a problem considering the whole point of the terminal was to provide immigration services to the offensively rich. This actually escalated to the point where there was talk of imprisoning the minister and the general of the Home Affairs Department if they wouldn't send the proper immigration officers. So, this led me to ask one final question that was just eating away at me the entire time I was researching this. Why? Why suddenly deny approving this terminal? It's not like he grew a conscience and decided to stop helping billionaires help billionaires. Well, the leading theory is that there is one group we haven't mentioned yet. And as we all know, if you say corruption in the mirror three times, a Gupta shows up. The Guptas allegedly interfered to stop the Oppenheimer's bid for the terminal after it had been successfully greenlit. Now, a majority of this theory revolves around a company called Denel, an arms company that the Guptas have about as much influence over as Trump does the Trump Organization. Now, this company is known to be pretty shady to the point where it wasn't allowed to do business in India until 2014 for being too corrupt. And even Enron was doing business in India. That said, the Guptas did help facilitate that relationship. Gigaba reversed and denied his approval just 5 days after giving it, after he received a letter from Denel chairman Dan Mancha, saying it could not go ahead for security reasons. Although, the security systems were successfully put to the test after, oh my god, are you serious? Well, okay. The Gupta company was caught trying to smuggle diamonds from that terminal. So, why do this? Well, it's probably a combination of, and excuse my language, a dick measuring contest between two of the richest families in South Africa, and the fact that the Guptas now want that terminal, which they may get considering the fact that it's losing 3 million rand a month. With all of this being the dominant theory, I could see how the courts would want to give Gigaba the severe punishment of potentially losing his cabinet position. And, oh, that's it? What does it take to get fired in South Africa? Does the Supreme Court have to find you guilty of corruption? In America, we literally fired the Secretary of State via tweet for disagreeing with the President over Russia. So, before I go, I also need to present Gigaba's side of the story, which goes beyond just saying it wasn't me and claiming all of the documentation is fake, which is why you don't make plans in secret. You end up with dubious terminals and $100 billion unconstitutional nuclear power projects. This next part was a little strange though, because he consistently goes on to explain. He rejected the proposal because it would be beyond his authority to designate a port of entry for exclusive private use by a family. Although, unfortunately for him, it was found that the way it was set up was within his authority, because it was an addition to the existing airport rather than a new airport itself. To which he replied, Gigaba's appeal has been rejected by the Constitutional Court, although it's still under review in the Supreme Court. So keep an eye out as we see if this long-standing politician will lose his cabinet position or not. As always, thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you want to support independent journalism researching South Africa, slam that subscribe button. And as always, thank you for watching.